talk about Velocity Banking plus Infinite Banking plus HSA. Here's a strategy that I am implementing in my own personal finances, and let's see how it turns out. Let's do the math. Let's run the numbers, right? Like I always say, gotta run the numbers. The first numbers we need to accumulate is our four major numbers. How much do you make per month? What are your expenses? What's your debt? What's the leftover cash flow after all bills, debts, living expenses, everything, taxes, all of it hasn't paid? What's left over? So for me, the first thing that I did before I reveal my current numbers is I 10x'd. Okay, 10x'd my income first. Every strategy that I implement now is simply an add-on feature. It's not my one and done financial freedom, wealth accumulation strategy. These are just simply features and benefits. 10x is the bread and butter. 10x is the one and only strategy that I do, that I recommend my clients to do if you truly want financial freedom in your life, which basically just means taking what you currently make right now and 10xing that number. If you did it at least once in your life, it would dramatically shift your perspective around money. So if you're making $2,000 a month, imagine what life would be like if you were making $20,000 a month. Just think about it. You know how to live on $2,000 a month right now. If all you did was add a zero and do not change your lifestyle for a good 10 years, oh my goodness, will you have a life of abundance? So I always like to put first and foremost, 10x first. Every other strategy that I talk about on this channel is simply an add-on feature. I don't even care how well it performs. I just know that they're good things to have, right? So HSA, I know it's a good thing to have. It's not my one and done strategy. It's not my, this is what I'm gonna live off of. No. This is just an add-on feature. I think it's cool. I think it's attractive. I think it's beneficial. Has its pros and cons, of course. The only con I see to the HSA is that the money is locked up. You can only use it for medical. That's what I hear the other side say. The positive side says, hey, there's great tax benefits, triple tax benefit. You can use it for medical. This is basically your stealth retirement account. You can self-direct it. You can invest, whatever it is. I don't care. I'm going to add it. I 10x'd my income. I don't know where else to put the money, right? So I'm going to keep learning and learning and learning, and let's see where it takes us. So with that being said, let's come back to the board. Income is 20K plus a month. Expenses are usually always 10K and under. Zero debt. Cash flow is 10K plus. This is average for my current numbers. Now, Velocity Banking, 10X. That's the first two strategies. Pay off all the debt. So I did Velocity Banking, paid off all the debt. 10X, my income went from 2K to 20K plus a month, right? My expenses, of course, rise because I have a business. But I still personally live on like 3K or less a month, right? When I was making $2,000 a month, I was living on $1,500. So I only increased my living, personal living, by 50%. That's about it, you know? By 100%, I'm sorry. So with that being said, those are your expenses, those are numbers, four major numbers, great. Now, Infinite Banking. I started a policy, I have two of them, but I'm gonna go over the main one that I have, which is with Guardian, one of the four major mutuals, putting in $70,000 a year, my premium is $7,000, so that's a 1090 split, this is a perfect split, maximizing on cash value. My MEC limit is $81,000. This does not mean that I can put in $81,000 each and every year. What it does mean is that I can put in $70,000 for a long period of time, right? Every 7 years, the MEC limit will adjust downward. Depending on how the insurance companies will determine that MEC, I do not know of that yet. But what I do know is that for the first 7 years, I can put in $70,000 without creating a MEC, right? Without this turning into a qualified retirement plan where I get taxed, right? If I want to remain this, if I want to keep this a tax-free asset, I must stay below the MEC, right? And follow the rules, basically. So the first 7 years, I'll be putting in 70,000, premium 70K. First year cash value is 60,829. I am now in 2020, it's February. I'm approaching my anniversary date on this policy. So I'll be putting in another 70K in principal. In addition to velocity banking, using a line of credit, credit cards, cash flow to fund this policy, which is going to yield anywhere from 4 to 6% tax-free every single year, no matter what, guaranteed, right? In addition to that, when I pull from the money, when I take out what's called a policy loan, I will not lose value in my cash value. This will not be affected no matter how long I have these loans outstanding. Am I going to keep them outstanding for very long? No. I have good flow, right? I have a good flow. I have a 10X system. So I'm going to keep putting in pure principal each and every year while simultaneously using that same money to fund an HSA. So coming over to here, here's the first account. This is the IBC account. I take out a policy loan, goes to the checking account, the business checking account. The limitation that you can fund an HSA right now, if you're single, is $3,550. So I put $3,550 from my business checking account into the HSA. I then self-direct it and invest. Option one, real estate. Option two, dividend investing. These are the two things that I would personally like to learn and master myself. So over the course of 10 to 15 years, I will be doing both. In today's just simple example, I used the dividend investing strategy, which simply means that instead of just buying stocks, I'm buying investments that pay me cash each and every year. No matter what happens to the value of the stock, I will still receive a dividend each and every year. Dividend investing. It's a great strategy. Been looking it up on YouTube. I like what people say about it. It's in alignment with the things that I do. Okay? So over the course of 10 to 15 years, putting in $3,550, I'm going to put in anywhere between $35,500 and $53,250 in principal. Let's say I got a growth rate of return, 8%. I believe personally that with my education so far and the access that I have to knowledge, I believe that if I just buy a couple courses, learn the thing, I can yield way more than 8%. But I'm going to keep it conservative. Let's just say 8% each and every year, no matter what. That's how much my account grows by. Putting in $3,550 into this HSA from the IBC policy. So that means each and every year I'm taking out a policy loan for $3,550. Into the business checking account, HSA, boom. I get a write-off for doing that, number one, on the $3,550, and the money gets to grow in the HSA tax deferred. The money can be used tax-free for medical expenses, right? It can also be used as a payout strategy if I save all my medical receipts throughout my whole lifetime till I'm like 59 and a half, right? I can accumulate a reimbursement like distribution. I can use that money now for anything, or a portion, not all of it, but I can use a big portion to basically have as tax-free income for a period of time, because I would just be simply reimbursing myself for all those medical bills, receipts that I saved throughout the years. So that when medical does get real expensive later on, not only do I have that tax-free money, but because the money can be used for medical, all of it is going to be used. So basically, there, what I've heard is, you know, right to an extent, that it is sort of like a stealth retirement account. I do like it. I like the fact that I can just kind of put money over there, not worry about it. You know, do some real estate investing or dividend investing. Those are two strategies that I like so far. So I, you know, I'm putting this, you know, little change each and every year, have that thing grow. I'll be able to connect with some people. I'm also doing the HSA so I can connect with other YouTubers that know everything about HSA, and they can teach me all the ins and outs about it. And then I create content around it and let's see what happens, right? So with that being said, let's say I did do this for about 10 to 15 years. I'll be 39 years old, have that money grow at 8%. I'll have over $106,670.09 over the course of 15 years, growing at just 8%. Now, I know in the videos that I've watched, like I said, I can probably double or triple that number. So that would just double or triple this number, right? So with that being said, I think it sounds great, right? This is not a 10x plan. This is simply an add-on feature to my 10x. I'm going to continue to 10x, right, and create multiplication. But it's nice to have these little side accounts, HSA, maybe a Roth, right, things like that, to have off to the side. These are great to have once you don't have any debt, right? But if you're someone that's in debt, and you have a 401k, you got a Roth, you got a TSP, you got a freaking HSP and a SEP 40 and whatever they're, I don't even know what they're called. We got all those things that are costing you money, fees, and on top of that, you're paying a bunch of interest on debt. It's wise to cut those things off temporarily. Redirect everything to paying off debt first, because you're going to make more money in the long run by simply wiping out all your debt that's costing you interest and fees now today, so that you can have more cash flow to work with to 10x, infinite banking, HSA, dividend investing, real estate investing, right? You have access and capital to more opportunities. So let me know what you guys think of this. I would like some feedback. Don't know everything about HSA. I don't really care, right? It doesn't matter to me. It's just a little feature, add on. But I wanted to, you know, reveal the things that I'm working on in my own personal finances so that you guys stay up to date and you get some ideas for those who are in debt and you're working your way out of debt, or you're doing velocity banking, infinite banking together. Here are some things to look forward to once you've wiped out all that bad debt, and now you're using debt to your advantage. You're leveraging, creating capital. Your credit score is great. Your cash flow is great. Hey, take a look at HSA. Take a look at real estate investing in general. Take a look at dividend investing. I like the idea of dividend investing because it doesn't require any physical work. It's all up here in the head. I'm going to use an app called Robinhood because that's what all the other YouTubers are using. And they're revealing their accounts. They're showing these big $300, $500 million accounts. I'm like, great, not bad, you know, cool videos, right? I'm gonna hook up with one of those guys and let's see where it goes from there. My name's Denzel Rodriguez, your personal finance geek. Have a wonderful day and God bless.